folks, I'm going to disappoint the guitar players today because Ali Benton sent me basses. And since I play bass as well, you know, it makes sense. I know many of you have asked for the basses, so it's not a huge disappointment. And I know some of you are bass players, so hey, this might actually work out well for all of us. Let's go right into it. You've heard them in the track, you've seen nice pictures. I don't quite know why you're still here, because everything you need to know you've already, you know, experienced. But hey, we're gonna go and start actually with the cheapest in the bunch, which is the Ali Benton PJ-4 HDR Deluxe E-Bass. PJ meaning it's a precision type bass with a precision type pickup in it, but it also has the single coil from a J-Bass, PJ. It's not pajamas.
I'm so funny.
Where is it? So, a couple of things about this bass. Body is Alder. I'm just reading from the website. You might as well get the same information without me. I don't know what you need me for. Body is Alder, bolt on neck, modern C shape that means nothing unless you actually play the damn thing. We have a rosewood fretboard, dot inlays, 20 frets, then there's lots of numbers, 22 millimeters on the saddle, blah, blah, blah. Double action truss rod, PJ style. Pickup configuration, 2 volume, 1 tone, volume, tone. I would assume I can't really hear too much on the tone, but we'll figure that out. Chrome hardware. Strings are 45 to 105. The color is red. In the pictures on the Thomann website, it looks very dark, and it does look kind of dark, but in this light right here, it looks very red. So, only in very nice lighting conditions will it actually look this red. And then it has this fake tortoiseshell pickguard. I said in one of the videos, why don't they use, you know, real tortoiseshell pickguards? Well, I didn't mean real tortoiseshell. That is stupid. I don't want to kill turtles. No, but this is a photo finish, photo thing. I think they should actually spend the extra couple bucks and make this real plastic all the way through tortoise. It looks a little bit fake. It looks faded. The creamy kind of color doesn't really work. I think the pickguards are the things that make this look cheap. I would rather take a black or white one over this because you look at it and it makes the bass feel cheap. We have big ass tuner heads right here. Look at this. The traditional big ass wingy, whatever they're called. I don't know, what are they called? Doesn't even say that. Open tuners. The amazing thing about this bass is. Look at this. Look at this neck. The neck actually looks as if it is like a flame maple. It is crazy. I don't know if any of the cameras can actually get this, but it's a crazy flame maple-y neck. It really is. The neck looks like $1,000. That is crazy. The way you're going to hear this is me going directly DI, this is pretty much how I record bass, into the Apollo. I'm going to, this is passive, so I'm going to add a little bit of gain. Gonna get both pickups up. So let's go through a couple of sounds to make you happy, okay? I'm gonna go and say we have volume, tone. So right now only the pickup. And only the J pickup. More mids. Thank you. Okay. And nothing is, well, nothing. Let's see if we have tone control here. The high end goes away, but all it does is it doesn't actually change the bass's tone. It changes the hiss that is there. I think the tone control is set too high. There's a little bit of hiss, you probably can't hear this. And if I roll this back, the hiss is gone. Yet, my bass this is set way too high in terms of frequency, so it's really kind of a pointless tone control. It plays beautifully. Here's the thing. Right now, as of the filming of this video, we're talking about 111 euro. That is crazy in ways that I can't possibly describe, because the action is fine. Playability is fine, sound is thick. As I said, this amazing flame maple neck, wow. I can't say anything else about this. Could slap, or if I could slap, I could actually show you how to slap on this, but I can. I don't know, but hey, let's take a pick. This is a Dunlop Ultex. Absolutely, in no way, any shape or form, anything wrong with this bass. Most certainly not for 111 euro. Let's stay fretted. We're going to the progressive series. This is active, which means I'm gonna have to take my level down here. Mm-hmm. The E string seems to crank out more level. Okay. So this thing is, I think, 139. You can also get it not in all the way black, but a little bit of a quilty thing going on for 149. Again, while I'm filming this, prices may change. Again, we have a... We don't have a neck platey thing here. But it's still a bolt-on neck, Canadian maple neck, with the headstock clearly attached here because it's angled. We have more modern tuners that are die-cast tuners. We have a balance, bass, treble, and volume. We'll find out which ones they are. We have 24 frets. No idea why a bass player would need this. Really, no idea. Definitely not on a bass like this. Then we have, again, 42 millimeters at the saddle. We have Tai Chi inlays. Tai Chi! And they're kind of cool. They're original. Nothing that you've seen before. They're, well, except on basses with Tai Chi inlays. And on the 12th fret, there's something more. Bass plays nice. And it's a little bit, well, because of the activeness, a little bit more active. Let's look at the controls. Well, that's obviously volume. Now we have balance. For me, 99% of the time, it's in the middle with the bass. It's the front. That's the bridge. The E string is stronger than the other strings. I think there needs to be a better balance. Then, not this balance, you know, a better balance. Then there's the, whatever this is, the bass and treble probably. I don't know what I'm doing. And no bass. Treble. Oh, okay. Have to find a position here for my finger. It really hurts my fingers. Very stramm im Ton. Very, tight. Let's pick it with a pick. Oh, wait, that's not an E string. I dropped D'd it for the track. Needs to do this if you ask me. Here we go. This is what you do. granted, all you're hearing is the DI sound. I put a little bit of EQ on there, a little bit of compression, but that is it. Through an actual bass cab and bass amp, this will sound so much fatter. And if you add a little bit of drive, just the tiniest bit, tubey kind of drive, not overdrive or distortion, this would be pretty damn killer. So, actually, you know what? We're here, why don't we try this? Why don't we try it? I've got this Blueberry Bass Overdrive here from Matt Professor, which granted, I would assume, probably costs more than the bass. Which is pretty ridiculous, if you think about it. But I'm supposed to test it, why not test it with you right now? I've never plugged this in. So, why not? Oh, also, this thing is supposed to go passive by pulling this. I completely forgot that. So, you pull this and you have passive. But that's almost no level at all. Let me crank that up to the level where I had the other one. Now you need a lot of level for that. Not sure if the passive really is a great idea on this bass. So let's be careful with it. We have nature, drive, and volume. Nature is probably a mix knob, I would assume. No, it's not. I would like to mix that in and not have that all the way. That's better. Nature cranked up, not so much drive. Still, I think I would want that dry and then mix that in. That would be a very nice signal. So, moving on to my favorite, which is the JB40 FLSB. JB40 FLSB. Where is it? It's a J-type bass. I'm gonna say jazz bass, and you know what? The big F can go and sue me. Because technically, I can call this a jazz bass, a blues bass, my mother is a nice mommy bass, whatever. I can say anything I want. So we have, I don't know what we have, a rosewood fretboard, bolt-on neck. We have ash body, American ash, not swamp ash, but ash. Beautiful body here. I can't really tell you where it's, or if at all, this is a two-piece, three-piece, whatever. You should be able to see that on the grain right here. Go ahead and study the grain. Can't really see if there are multiple parts. There's a skunk stripe in the back out of rosewood. And that's where the double action truss rod comes in. We have Wilkinson, MWBJPJ, El Nico JB style single coils, volume, tone, the Darios are on it. And classic butterfly, that's what they're called, butterfly tuners, open in the back. And we have beautiful, it looks like wood, I don't know, it might be filler material. inlays that show you where you're supposed to be. So fret inlays, but no actual frets, because this is fretless, means no frets. The dots on the side are nice, but they're not centered. We had that problem on the HB35 hollow body. And here again, they are generally too low. They're not centered. They should work on this. So we're going to crank up both pickups and just give it a whirl. Since it's passive, I'm going to increase the volume again. So this is just beautiful. I've never ever played anything like this on bass before. And you know it's an amazing instrument when it makes you do shit that you didn't know you wanted or could do. Wow. Pickup. Thinner, but more. And then only the front. And the tone. Just amazing, but let's, for shits and giggles, compare it. here's the fretless I usually play, the Magnus Guitars Sharky 6-string, completely handmade German boutique luthier bass, okay? Passive, Bartolini, I think, yeah, this is as good as basses get. And that's what I usually play, so let's see. There's nothing in the fretboard. It's really fucking you up, trust me. Folks, we are very, 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 very far apart when it comes to price here, okay? More output, fuller. This clocks in at 149. Buy one right now, seriously. Holy fucking shit. Yeah, okay, well, I'll be right back. I need the faith, but no one out there really knows my name. My two cents? Well, there's absolutely nothing wrong with these bases. Saying that means they're okay. That's bullshit. Well, obviously, well, on the PJ, the dots were a little bit too low. Do you give a flying rat's ass? That thing is $111. What the fuck? The neck looks like it's flame maple. Maybe not every single one is. Well, that piece is, and that is stunning. It does a fine job. Maybe the tone pot could be more effective to really make it rounder. Well, if it doesn't, who gives a flying rat's ass? €111. The progressive, it's a little bit too black for me. It's too much high gloss, too much black. The sound is great. The passive sound doesn't have enough output. That doesn't work for me. Yet again, for $139. A fine bass if you want to do the heavier stuff, not because it sounds heavier, you can totally do that on the PJ, but simply because the visuals work. The visuals support that heavy stuff. Unless you want to do Iron Maiden-y kind of stuff, then this visual totally works. The fretless is... I have no words for it. You could play this for hours by itself, just no effects, no anything. Just play it and have fun. It's round, it's beautiful. It is a great bass. These things, folks, are not just beginner basses. They are great beginner basses, okay? They are absolutely great for beginners because that's the price range that beginners invest in. So all of them absolutely recommended. Maybe not the fretless because fretless might not be the beginner bass. But... there are way more, as we've just seen with the fretless in comparison. They are definitely way more than only beginner instruments. I would gig with any of them immediately. I'm actually thinking about keeping the fretless. And sometimes I play cover gigs or whatever. Some people ask me to play bass for them, which is, you know, nice. It's fun. And I would strap that sucker on and play it, no questions asked. Absolutely. Might not look as cool as that surfboard of that six string, but it does a fine job, trust me. So if you're in the market for a bass, all of these clock in at under $200, and I can't find anything wrong with them. I have fun, they work in produced tracks as you've seen. What else do you need to know? Nothing. See you guys. Highly recommended. Absolutely.
Hey, warum ist hier nur einer und das? Hey, wie kommt das hin?
Das ist einfach schwer.
Nein.